Yo, what's going on, everyone? Nelson Chan from Hoopland. Today I bring you a super highly anticipated sneaker review, the Jordan Why Not Zero Ones. Man, that was a really long name. This is Russell Westbrook's first on-court signature sneaker, and ever since he was signed with Jordan Brand, he's always wore, you know, Jordan Brand player exclusives, but he was never dubbed his own signature shoe. But the time is now more like ahead of our time, because the shoe here looks crazy and futuristic. In my hands, I have the mirror image colorway, which looks super duper dope. It has a ton of crazy graphics on the upper from Russell Westbrook banging out, Jordan himself, quotes, the world, and a bunch of other images. There is the Russell Westbrook logo on the strap, and beneath it, there is the why not on the tongue. Russell Westbrook's motto defines how he plays, how he dresses, it defines how people don't think he can succeed, and basically, you know, anyone who criticizes him. But his response to all the haters is, why not? And I have a lot of good things to say about the shoe, so let's get into the review. For traction, the Why Not Zero One has a multi-directional herringbone traction pattern outsole. On my pair, I have a translucent outsole, while the two-way white and black colorway dropping later next month will have a solid rubber outsole. To me, the outsole has these little nubs that kind of remind me of the Kobe 10 and Jordan 28 outsole. The traction is pretty inconsistent depending on the course you're playing on. On super clean courts, these work fantastic. They grip really hard, and basically you're able to move whatever direction you want pretty well, where you have great stop and reacting movements. But on mildly dusty courts, at times you might have a little bit of slipping. There were a few times in the review and in pickup games where I was going 1,000 miles per hour, and if I were to make a hard change in direction, or if I were to stop really hard on a dime, or just plant, you know, to do a layup or a dunk, and I would have that slippage in the backside where I kind of almost turned my foot. So with that, I would suggest you guys, you know, to wipe the bottom of the shoe pretty frequently, especially if you guys are hooping in a dusty court. Whereas dust do get absorbed into the outsole because the traction pattern is pretty narrow, dust might get stuck in there, so you guys gotta make sure to wipe your shoes. And because the outsole of the traction pattern is pretty soft and narrow, I wouldn't recommend you guys to hoop in these outdoors, as it might get ruined quickly. But for the most part, traction on the Why Not Zero Ones, I would say, is pretty good. Moving on to the materials, the Why Not Zero One has a mesh upper for lightweight containment, along with a smooth vamp cover and a jagged heel counter. The shoe feels pretty bulky at the bottom, but it doesn't play bulky. It's fairly similar to the Jordan 32s, but the Jordan 32 plays bulky, as the materials on those are heavier compared to these. The mesh upper and the vamp right here is very flexible, very lightweight, where it gives you really good comfort on the upper. Because the shoe is all covered up right here, you don't get that great of a ventilation. After every hoop session, it does get pretty toasty in there. The heel counter in the back may seem and look like it's very big and bulky, which in a sense it kind of is, but like I said, it doesn't play bulky. It's actually really sturdy, and it doesn't really hinder performance that much. Overall, the upper and the materials on the shoe, I would say, is pretty good. It's comfortable, and the graphics being printed on it just makes it look hella dope. For support and lockdown, the shoe has a mini strap at the top, along with internal laces with an Air Jordan 6 and inspired lace lock. It also has a really big and wide outrigger, giving you great lateral support. Containment was a huge component for Russell Westbrook in making of his shoe, especially forefoot containment, as he's always on his forefoot ready to explode. And that's great, because I believe most hoopers play on their forefoot most of the time anyways. The lockdown on these is really great. You have the secure lacing system, along with the non-stretchable vamp, along with the beefy padding inside of the heel, is just awesome. It really locks in your foot into place where it won't be moving around. In terms of having great lockdown and support and good forefoot containment, Russell Westbrook says it's very, very important to him that it allows him to move at a very fast pace. And you guys know that Russ needed this massive outrigger right here, you know, for when he does his super explosive Euro steps, you know what I'm saying? He'd be like, he'd be going from Mars all the way to Jupiter, back to the Earth, and, you know, finishing the play. That's just how explosive of a player that he is, and this shoe right here provides that great support and lockdown with great forefoot containment for him to explode in any direction where his foot will be secure. The strap is okay. It doesn't really help that much. Aesthetically, I think it looks great, but sometimes it does get kind of annoying having it to put it on and off. Especially when you're tying your laces, kind of gets in the way. But you can kind of just tuck it in right here. But like I said, it doesn't really help that much in terms of performance. Only problem here is actually getting your foot into the shoe. I mean, it is kind of a pain in the butt, because it's pretty snug right here. It's not that stretchable, especially with the lace lock right here, where you have to, you know, adjust all the time. But, you know, I personally do not like the lace lock. I actually took it off. I think it feels better in the shoe. Plus, it helps you get your foot into the shoe a little bit easier. And once your foot is in there, it's locked in and secure. For cushion, the Y901 has a full-length Zoom Air unit with a compression-molded Phylon foam piece. Alright, the shoe already had me when it said full-length Zoom. For all y'all who know me, full-length Zoom Air is the greatest cushioning setup that I like personally. And when they said they have full-length Zoom Air in these, I got pretty excited. The cushioning on these actually do feel a lot similar to the Jordan 32s, except it's a little softer and a little squishier. It does take a little bit of time to break in, but after that, it feels super comfortable. It's super responsive. I mean, y'all seen the Bang Outs in these, right? That's when you know the shoe is made just for me and that it was super explosive and super responsive. I mean, this is Russell Westbrook's shoe, which some people say is my NBA comparison. I wish. Maybe just a little bit. As I mentioned before, it does feel a bit clunky on the bottom as the Zoom Air is bottom loaded and also where the midsole isn't that flexible, but it doesn't really hurt the performance that much. And just because it's not flexible doesn't mean it'll hurt you. It actually gives you a little bit of a boost because it has that pushback from the shoe not being able to bend. Impact protection on these is great. I'd be jumping onto the moon and back where my landing might be a little bit scary sometimes, but the shoe has my back in terms of impact protection. And although it's not that low to the ground as some of y'all may like, but it still does have pretty good core feel. As far as comfort and size fit, the Y901 runs true to size. I didn't have any issues in terms of, you know, the shoe not fitting well. The fitment on these are just great. Overall, the shoe feels pretty comfy besides this one issue that I had. The lace lock actually digs into your foot a little bit when you tie your shoelaces pretty tight. I personally, like I said, I didn't like the lace lock even being there. It doesn't help with performance. And I actually took them both out as I like the shoe better without them. Besides that, overall, I didn't have any discomfort in these. They feel amazing and are really comfortable. As far as pricing, the Y901 retails for $125, a really affordable price for the amount of performance that you're getting. And did I not already mention you'll get full-length Zoom for $125? You can't beat that. The mirror image colorway that I have is already sold out by now, but the next colorway that's gonna drop, the two-way colorway, the black and white pair, is gonna retail later next month, February 15, also for $125. And for my overall rating for the Y901s, like I mentioned in the previous video, we do have a new grading scale. The score for the grading scales for the shoes is gonna be rated out of 5, 5 being the highest and best, while 1 being the lowest and the worst. And with that being said, the Y901 deserves a 4.5 out of 5. Price and cushioning alone gives these at least a 4. I mean, you're getting full-length cushioning for $125. You get great comfort in the upper end materials while having good support and lockdown. Traction can be inconsistent depending on the court you're playing on, but on clean courts, like I said, they work fantastic. And on mildly dusty courts, when times get rough, all you gotta do is just wipe the shoe a little bit and you're good to go. And as I mentioned before, there is no particular shoe that's perfect for everyone. This shoe may be perfect for me, but it may not be perfect for you. It all depends on what you like in a shoe and what you look for in a shoe and how you play. If you like high flying responsiveness, a little push cushioning, and good support, these are the joints for you. But if you like a super lightweight shoe, low to the ground, and a lot of court feel, these may not be the shoe for you. As I've always mentioned, it all comes down to player preference. And I know aesthetically, a lot of y'all might not like how the shoe looks, but I personally think it looks super duper dope, especially with the mirror image colorway with the super crazy graphics on the shoe. And like I said, man, the shoe doesn't cater to everyone, but I personally think the shoe looks super dope. To me, the Y901 is gonna go down as one of the top performance hoop shoes this year. I mean, I don't see why not. Thank you guys for watching that sneaker review on the Jordan Y901s, Russell Westbrook's first signature shoe, man. I've been super excited. I've been hella anticipating this shoe. Russell Westbrook is one of the most exciting players, and like people say, the shoe feels amazing. Hope you guys enjoyed that video. Make sure to check out these other videos right here. If you guys like the content, make sure to subscribe to the channel. Also, check out my social media in the description box down below. And until next time, stay tuned for more videos coming, and I'm out. Peace.